I'm just trying to run through the money, run. Yeah. I'm just trying to run through the money, run. Run through it, yeah. I'm trying to blow a check, I'm trying to blow a check, I'm trying to pull up in the phone and make the niggas out to say, run through the money, run.
I know what you guys are thinking. You're probably thinking Nico's full of shit, Nico's full of whatever for meeting up with me, but if I want to be the best in this industry or try to at least get to the top, I need to work with the best. And therefore, I know what Nico can offer, and I'm pretty sure he knows what he don't really know what I can offer yet because I'm just starting this business, but I can offer Nico a lot, just as well as he can offer me a lot. So, I mean, why not reach out for help? I promise there will be no intertwining, no feelings, no nothing. I just want to work. I'm just here for business.
All right. So, honestly, what I invited you out here for, we're going to have a brief discussion. A couple things. Mm-hmm. Nothing too major. But for starters, I would like to say I'm not with Alonzo.
Don't say you're not.
No. That was just a random fling. Like, it wasn't anything major, anything serious. Just want to self heal over it. It wasn't, no. Drunken night, couple shots, awkward situation. Sorry, that's happening. I know you probably fucking hate me for it. But can't really say too much about it.
After the fiasco downtown with me and Chris, he hit me up, text me, you know, saying he wants to meet somewhere alone so we can have a civilized conversation and everything. And like I said before, I feel like I went off on him prematurely, even though I feel like I had every right to cuss him out. I still didn't really get to hear his side of the story, which might not mean nothing. I might be stupid just for meeting him here, but I do want to see what he has to say for himself.
I mean, when I heard about it, it was like, I was more confused than anything because you and Alonzo both talk so much shit about each other. And then to hear that y'all were messing around after me and you got back cool, it was just like, every time I think you can't do something that will surprise me, you will do something that just is like so fucked up, but I'm just like speechless, so. It wasn't much that I could say about it, if that's what it was, but
I mean, honestly, that's just a situation you would have to been there to see how it happened. Honestly, I could say I was not in the wrong in this situation. I was in the wrong when I kept it going, but when it happened, honestly, that was not me. I was drunk. He was supposed to be my ride to my car. I took advantage of his opportunity to get there. But like I said, we're not together. That was just a little small part about what I was talking about. I wouldn't call it sex.
Y'all fuck.
I wouldn't call it a fuck.
More was like, there any penetration involved?
That's not really what I want to talk to you about. What I really need, honestly, Nico, you're wonderful in this business. And I'm trying to turn a new leaf in my life. I want to branch out. I want to do new things. Is there any way in your heart you can kind of help
me? You're asking me to work with you?
Just a little bit. Just help. I just need your help for the time being. I'm trying to branch out. I'm trying to start a new modeling career. And there's no one other than you. I mean, who else out here that can help? You're great at what you do, so I mean, can you find in your heart to help me?
In true Chris fashion, y'all know him better than I do. He follows the same pattern every time. He disrespects me, and then all of a sudden he starts crawling back asking for my help. But this time it's different. This time he's asking me to work with him. Now, Chris has never asked me to work with him in the past, even when we were together. But, I don't know, it was like a... something I had to really give a serious thought about, because if Chris is serious, if he's really serious about wanting to, you know, further his business career and his modeling career or whatever, and I'm all for helping him out. But he has to promise me that there will be no drama, no personal connections between me and him, no hitting my phone up all night, all time of the night and everything like that. Like, we gotta keep it strictly professional and keep it on 100, like, just work, just business partners, that's it. So as long as he can keep his word and keep his promise about that, then I might can consider working with him. But if there's any kind of slip up, any kind of, then I'm backing out and I'm just gonna wash my hands clean of him.
If I help you, Chris, it has to be strictly professional and just business. I don't want to be involved in any drama whatsoever. I don't know who the hell you was with the other night at the downtown. I don't care to know. But if you're not with Alonzo, then with Alonzo, that's great to know. I won't ask you anything else about that situation because I'm strict, like, I'm really over him and I'm getting past that whole situation. So, if I work with you, it has to just be business.
That's all I'm asking for, strictly business.
And, like, nothing, no more, games, like, nothing.
Nothing more, nothing less, strictly business. You get your check, I get mine.
I can do that.
Okay. Like, I love.
Not a small one?
No.
Handshake.
That'll work.
Well, I will see you around or whatever, and we'll talk about this. And we'll go from there.
Alright. I appreciate you. Thank you.
Oh, gosh.
Money and shit, it's so fucking crazy that I can't take it! Right? Hey, Bunny was fucking right the whole fucking time by all this dumb shit. Now I'm fucking walking around here with these dumb niggas.
I can't keep on doing the same thing like I was doing over and over again. I can't take it anymore.
But you ain't gotta. You ain't got to. I mean, I'm here, so.
What you gonna do for me that I can't do already?
I mean, you wanna live this lifestyle?
No.
I want you to stop.
By doing what?
I mean, you can be my girl, you know what I'm saying? But you gonna have to change your ways. If you don't change, man, I gotta cut you.
How I'm gonna make money, though? That's what I wanna know.
The right way. Like every person around here, a job, a 9-to-5 is not bad.
Yeah, it's not. But I need my money, though.
So, what you gonna do?
I agree with you. I'ma quit.
For real?
I promise you I'm gonna quit.
Give me your word that you gonna stop.
What you want me to do?
Come with me.
I'ma quit.
Come with me. Come stay with me.
Right now?
Yeah, right now.
Let's go.
Girl, you
I guess I do. You go first.
Okay.
Dawn has been MIA, and I don't mean that in no shady way, but it's like, this bitch be busy now. Like, I'll never get to see her, but whenever we do link up, we'll go grab a bite to eat or anything like that. So she hit me up, and we went to go to Subway, just, you know, catch up on what's been going on in each other's lives.
Could I have, y'all have that turkey Italiano? Oh, okay. Could I have a 6-inch turkey Italiano on the Italian bread? I can get up, how tall are you? Six on Italian. That should be love.
For real, for real. What's that?
Thank you. Oh, wait. Can I get you, white
plastic? Don't get that part.
What's been going on? What you been up to? You been busy a lot? Because I haven't heard from you in like a little minute.
Yeah, they always say to be the story. But, good, just working. I actually just moved into a new apartment, so
okay.
I'm settling in to my new place. It's really nice. So, yeah, work, money. Really, my main focus right now. But it get lonely though. You know.
I bet. Hectic. Your schedule be crazy. I bet.
I've been working, so I'm trying to get my shit together. And as far as like, I'm mostly like doing like a lot of school, trying to hurry up and finish like as fast as I can.
Yeah.
But other than that, it's like,
it's been
like,
bitch.
Yeah. It's been like a lot of events and stuff, a lot of parties, trying to keep it all together. But so far, so good.
That's good. Doing something positive with yourself.
Meeting new people and stuff.
Yeah.
Connecting and networking and stuff.
Okay. Child, stay official because ain't no time to sleep. Ain't no time to sleep.
Right.
When you got shit to do. We young and ambitious, so, you know, at least we out here trying to do something. Because a lot of people that aren't, or flex like they're doing something, but really they're not.
Right. That's on the gram and stuff.
On our channel, on the gram.
On the gram.
Okay. For the snap. I get tired of people snapping. And then I'm trying to put every little single thing that they doing. Bitch, I see your meal. Okay, bitch, I ate today.
That's great.
Bite sandwich. Oh. Well, I'm gonna try to.
Oh, he just moved back?
Yeah.
Dawn tells me about Lamar moving back to the Queen City. And initially, I'm just thinking, like, okay, who cares? Not in a shady way, but it's just the fact that I haven't spoken to Lamar since our little incident last year. And I've moved completely past it. Now, if he's moved past it or not is really none of my concern. But we're eventually gonna cross paths, I'm sure. I mean, but I have no issue with him, and hopefully he has no issue with me. I guess we'll find out eventually, but it is what it is. As of right now, I wish him all the best.
I hear Justin's here.
That's cool.
That's cool, Chad. That was the best.
I mean, that's my first like time hearing about that, but yeah, that's cool.
Oh, it's all, he didn't tell you he was here?
I haven't spoken to him since last year.
Damn, bitch, a whole year now. Damn.
Like the whole situation went down, and I knew, like, you know, he told me he moved and stuff. I haven't, like, I've reached out to him, but I haven't heard anything back, so that's my
So you tried to communicate with him, and he didn't get back to you at all?
Yeah.
Oh, trust me, I didn't know. Like, we still keep in touch and stuff, but it was never brought up, you know what I'm saying? So I didn't know that y'all were not communicating.
How is he?
He's good. Just, trying to get settled back into Charlotte and everything, but he's good.
Okay.
Y'all need to link up or something. No? No. Darn.
I'm good on that. I mean, it's just where I'm at right now, I feel like it's best that we just, you know,
if we cross paths, we cross paths, that's fine, but I don't have it like on my to-do list, like to just make amends. Cause I have reached out and stuff. I ain't got no like ill feelings, nothing like that. But it's like, you know, if he's doing good, I'm doing good. It's like, you know, right. We should keep it like that. Cause I'm not trying to have like any beef this year or any like, you know, things going on. It's like, you know, it's just a lot of things that I'll be hearing and stuff. It's like, I feel like it's best for my interest just to leave that alone for right now anyway.
Well,
I wish you all the best of luck though, for
that's real. That's good. I was just gonna say, I don't like to put stuff in the air or whatever, but you know, you might run into him. I mean, the city is not, but so be it.
I'm sure I will. I don't know, you know, we be around the same people, mm-hmm. going to like the same events and stuff. But as long as I don't get no negativity or nothing like that, I mean, I'm good. But I know how he can be.
Right. You know how you can be too.
I know how I can be too, but I've changed a little bit. I know how much he's changed and stuff. You know, I'm trying to grow up and just be more mature.
Grow maturity, right.
So, you know, it is what it is, but as of right now, I'm gonna steer clear of that. So I don't wanna go. I don't know how.
Right. Don't talk.
I don't.
Dang, that's crazy. I didn't know y'all can talk.
I think you feel kind of salty.
I'm actually kind of glad that he did because, you know, that's my friend and not saying I believe, but the streets do talk and I have heard about the situation and I don't want my friend getting hurt. So I just want to make sure everything is all good between you and him.
Yeah, everything is awesome right now. Like I said, I reached out to him, you know, instead of, you know, taking a relationship path, I just decided, you know, how about do a business path?
Okay.
I mean, I want to work with the business.
You know, I also heard that you were trying to get into business.
Yes.
Okay, you know, I could also help you out with that a little bit.
I hope so. That'd be actually great. I'm kind of glad he did send this meeting up.
I'm definitely, you know, open to meeting new people and new talent as well, so.
I mean, I have heard about you. Heard you get a little defensive, so I made sure I said Crystal.
Yeah, you got to make sure you get that accent.
Right,
the accent over the A, you have to make sure that's just my name, and I need my name to be right when it comes out of your mouth. You know what I mean? So, but don't take it personal. That's just me. Trust me. When you get to know me, you'll love me.
So, I mean, it wouldn't be a problem working with you and Nico both at the same time?
Not at all. I mean, unless Nico would have a problem with that, no. I don't see no issue.
I mean, like you tell me all the time, you're a bitch, so.
I am. But yeah, I'm definitely, looking forward to working with you and, you know, just let me know exactly what you want to do and I got you.
All right, so I'll be about coming by your office to do some paperwork and everything? Yeah,
we can definitely do some paperwork.
All right, cool. Maybe we should exchange numbers, so.
Yeah, most definitely. So Nico sets up this little meeting with me and Chris tonight and, you know, of course I'm going to go. I'm always open to meeting new people and, of course, taking in new talent. So, you know, we're going to go talk some business. And now that I got the chance to actually talk to Chris, I do have a couple questions for him. So, I'm just a little curious. And okay. If you don't mind me asking, Alonzo.
What about him?
What's up with you and him?
Nothing. That was a thing of the past. We don't talk anymore. We don't communicate. I cut all ties off of him. I mean, like I said, I know you. I'm pretty sure you have heard a lot about the situation, considering that you are best friends with Nico. But that's a thing of the past. Chris is solo.
I was just a little curious about it, Nico. I mean, I don't too much know the situation, so of course I'm not going to speak on it. That's why I asked. I was just curious.
Problem, but one thing I am curious about, I'm not gonna lie, you say the streets do talk, I heard you're a little feisty. And considering that I am new into the game, I just don't want anyone trying to give off a bad reputation. I don't want my managers out here kicking ass. I don't want none of that. Like, honestly want a smooth sailing with this new path in my life.
Okay, that's understandable. But listen, you don't know me right now.
Okay.
You only know what you're told and what you hear. The streets do talk, but the streets not always true.
Okay.
But, you know, just get to know me. You'll see for yourself.
But not on top of that you're, you know, kind of feisty, I also heard that you sleep with your clients. I mean, you know, you're a very attractive lady, you know. You're very beautiful, but honestly, if I have to get into this business, that's not the role I'm trying to take. That's just not my style.
I feel you, and honestly, I never mix my pleasure with my business. That's something that is not a good mixture to me. It's something that I would never do, ever. No. Fucking my clients, like what? Who? Honestly, who got time for that? Like really? Who got time? Me. I do. Fuck my clients. Certain ones, like, why not? We both winning. You know what I'm saying? We both winning. You know what I mean? I completely understand exactly where you're coming from. Just to let you know, you don't have to worry about anything like that. When it comes to my business and my paper, I always keep it professional. Nothing comes in front of my paper.
Awesome, same here. I mean, we stay on the same track. I could be a power team.
You'll be good, honey. So, you know, my curiosity is all over the place tonight. Are you and Nico still fucking? I'm just curious. It's just a question. You don't have to answer, but I want an answer.
I wouldn't say. Just
basically. So, I came out of nowhere with this little question and whatnot. Of course I want to know if Chris and Nico are still fucking. I mean, Nico's my bitch, but like, he won't spill the tea to me about Chris. He think he's spilling it, but I don't feel like he giving it all to me. So, I asked for a second opinion.
We're still in contact, I would say. Like, say for instance, if I want to hang out with him, I mean, he's more than willing to hang out with me if I want to go to his house, you know. I can go to his house, he can come along. You know, we kick it from time to time. I wouldn't necessarily say we're fucking, but, I mean, we do our thing.
I think that's good that you guys at least have a good friendship.
Yeah, our relationship is very cordial. Like,
that's good.
That's why I reached out to him. Like, I know he wouldn't deny me.
That's good.
I feel like my overall meeting with Crystal, it went really well. She seemed like an excellent person. I am so excited to finally work with her. I heard a lot of great things about her, even though, like I said, I did hear little things that made me think in the head. But like I said, I'm very interested in where it goes. And if she thinks I'm gonna let her interrogate me, try to find out shit about me and Nico. Like I said, I give her all the information she needs to know.
Well, enough with this interrogating shit.
Right.
We got each other's number, so mm-hmm. We'll definitely keep in contact. You know, like I said, I got you. Trust me, you are going to love what we got going on.
As long as you got me, I got you. Alright. Which way did you park?
Over there.
Alright.
Okay, honey.
I'm happy now. I'm just proud of myself that Ashley came back and now.
It just feels so good now that I'm in my own home. And don't gotta worry about anything. Yeah, I mean, it's really roomy. Like, it's very spacious and stuff like that. And my room's already put together. So that's one thing I'm proud of. That I actually got my shit. Ooh, it's hot. I got everything. I just need to get my living room stuff. Of course I'm gonna see my address. Okay, but don't come here with the ratchet shit. You know you a little ratchet. All right. All right, I love you too. See you soon. Start of a great year, Lamar. A great year.